guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I'm sure you know what today's topic is based on the title of this video. Lately, a lot of things on YouTube have been bothering me, like people humiliating others because they don't agree with what the other person is doing, or people pointing out other people's flaws, or people saying that other people aren't right, or just all kinds of things have really been upsetting me lately about YouTube, and I wanted to point something out today. If you watch this channel, you know me as a positive person. I try to spread positivity and things like that. I want people to be happy and positive. I don't want to be negative in any way, and I hope I don't come across as negative in this video, because that is the opposite of what I'm trying to do. I am trying to defeat the negativity. So the title is pretty self-explanatory, and like I mentioned in the beginning, you know, there's people on YouTube that are calling people out because of the fact that they don't like what the other person is doing. And there was an instance where this certain creator, as mentioned in the title, called out another creator and humiliated them so much to where they didn't want to do YouTube anymore. It really makes me sad, because standing up for a cause that you believe in shouldn't be dragging other people down. As a Christian, I feel like God is the only way. He is a necessity in my life, and I feel like he could be a necessity in a lot of people's lives. I feel like if people don't have him in their life, it's detrimental. Me and vegans have a lot in common. We stand up for a lifestyle that we know is a necessity in other people's lives. And yes, I said lifestyle. Just like Christianity, veganism is a lifestyle. It's a choice. Whether you want to admit it or not, it's a choice. Just like bathing and brushing your teeth is a choice. You don't have to do them, but they're a necessity to your life. It really hurts me that people are being called out and humiliated for a lifestyle that they choose to live. Because at the end of the day, you can't force anything on anybody, and there's no way that you can change their mind. Saying that others are wrong for a lifestyle that you don't agree with is like saying it's wrong for a dog to lick its butt. Of course, it's gross, it's disgusting, and you don't agree with it. But there's nothing that you can say to make that dog stop doing what he's doing. I used to smoke cigarettes, and a lot of my family didn't agree with the life that I chose to live. I chose to put toxins into my body. I chose to destroy my lungs. I chose to lose one more breath. But at the end of the day, it was my choice. Did my family humiliate me because of it? No. Did my family call me out because of it? No. My family accepted it. They accepted that what I was doing was wrong, but there's nothing that they could do to change my mind. I think my question is to you, is what is your benefit? I understand that you're trying to raise awareness, but is it at somebody else's expense? If you don't have impact in your words and all you spew out is negativity, what you say is not going to affect them. Sometimes you just have to agree to disagree. I watch this creator's videos, and I noticed that they take clips from other creators' Snapchats, Facebooks, Instagram, YouTubes, etc. Why would you go out of your way to humiliate somebody because they're not living the lifestyle that you agree of? Why would you go out of your way to be so negative? If you want to stand up for something, stand up for it positively. Don't be negative, don't be hateful, and don't be mean. There's a difference between caring and bullying. Bullying is using superior strength to force someone to do what one wants. A superior strength would be using a vegan community or a social media following to taunt the creator or person to doing something that you want them to do. As a Christian, I stand up for poverty, pro-life abortion, and positivity, but I don't victimize a single person in the process. Honestly, I agree with you, and I agree with what you stand up for. You stand up for the well-being of animals, and I support that. But I don't agree with you victimizing and humiliating other people because they don't stand up for the same thing as you. Earlier, I mentioned that I stand up for poverty. I have donated my clothes at the Salvation Army. I've also volunteered there a few times, and I regularly volunteer at the food bank. But what have you done besides making response videos? What action have you taken to stand up for what you truly believe in? Have you done protests against animal cruelty? Have you volunteered your money or time to the RSPCA? What do you do besides hating people for making choices that you don't agree with? And yes, it is a conscious choice. Like I said, I don't want to be negative. but I do want to stop the negativity. I hate seeing people being victimized and creating YouTube videos while doing so. Just because they share their life doesn't mean you can judge them. So I hope everybody has taken something out of this. This really and truly came from my heart because I just hate seeing people bullied. I hate seeing people victimized for something that they choose to do. And I know that everybody doesn't agree with everybody. You know, that's just life. Sometimes that's just gonna happen. I don't agree with some people for doing some things, and I'm sure that some people don't agree with me for doing some certain things. You know, like, that's just how life is. So I hope everybody can understand that and respect people for having different opinions. Like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a huge thumbs up if you liked it. Make sure to subscribe for more videos down below. And I guess I'll see you guys in my next one. Stay beautiful. Mwah.